The next numerical method for root finding that I want to discuss is called Newton's method, named after Isaac Newton. Newton invented the calculus, so the method fittingly uses calculus. So this is a very fast method, in fact, the fastest method and very important method for solving problems that require speed. So let's have a look at how to derive this method. This is our xy axis. We're trying to find the root of y equals f of x. Let's draw the function here. So say this is y equals f of x, okay? The root is the intersection with the x-axis. Okay, this is an iteration method. So let's say that we're already iterated n times. So we're at the value of xn. So let's say this is xn. How do you find xn plus 1? Well, in Newton's method, you draw the tangent line to the curve at x equals xn. So if I can try to sketch the tangent here, it should look something like that. Okay? That, say, is the tangent line. You find the tangent line from calculus, right? The slope of this line is equal to the derivative of f evaluated at xn, right? Newton's calculus. And then the point of intersection with the x-axis here will become our next guess for the root, xn plus 1, okay? So we want to calculate a formula then for xn plus 1. So we need to write down the equation for this line. So what's the equation for the line? We know the point xn, yn here. So let me just call this one yn, right? We know yn is equal to f of xn. So we have the equation for the line then is delta y. So y minus yn is equal to the slope f prime of xn times delta x, so times x minus xn, okay? And then we're trying to find xn plus 1. So we want to find x equal to xn plus 1. And then the value of y when x equals n plus 1 is equal to 0, okay? And furthermore, we know y sub n equals f of x sub n, okay? That gives us the equation. Y is 0, so 0 minus f of xn is equal to f prime of xn times, x is xn plus 1, times xn plus 1 minus xn. Okay? That gives us an equation for xn plus 1, so we can solve that. And we get xn plus 1 is equal to xn minus f of xn over f prime of xn with a little bit of algebra. So this is the equation for Newton's method of root finding. It requires an initial guess, x naught. X naught should be close to the root. Otherwise, you can run away from the root. But if you guess a root close enough to the root, you can get convergence to the root very quickly. Okay, let's try an example. So again, we're going to find square root of 2. And the value is 1.41421. Okay. So we're going to iterate here. We have our equation. So f of x is our equation for square root of 2. So it's x squared minus 2, right? Our equation for f of x, that the root of this equation will be square root of 2. We need the derivative, so f prime of x is equal to 2x. And then Newton's iteration will be xn plus 1 equals xn minus f of x, xn, f of xn, xn squared minus 2 over 2xn. And this is what you would program in a computer. This would be your correction factor to xn. But by a hand calculation, it's easier to combine them. So if I put them under 2xn, we'll have 2xn squared minus xn squared, which is xn squared plus 2 over 2xn, okay? For a hand calculation. Okay, so let's try this. We can choose a value of x naught. Let's take x naught equal to 1. Then our value of x1 from our formula here would be 1 plus 2, which is 3 divided by 2. So 1 plus 2 over 2 is 3 halves, which is 1.5. Our value of x2 then would be n equals 1, so x1 squared, so 3 halves squared is 9 quarter, plus 2, divided by 2 times 3 halves, divided by 3. So this is 17 divided by 12. 17 divided by 12 is 1.416 bar there, okay? Remember, square root of 2 is 1.41421, so we're already like getting fairly close. Okay, let's try x3. What does x3 give us? X3 then will be x2 squared, so 17 over 12 squared plus 2 divided by 2 times 17 over 12, which is 17 over 6. Okay, this is a rational number. All the approximations here will be rational numbers. Square root of 2 is an irrational number. This one, you can use a calculator. I can't do that in my head. 577 over 408, okay? Which, if you do this in decimal, is 1.41426. 1.41426. So just this digit is wrong, okay? So you see that after three iterations, we're already getting pretty close to the square root of 2, converging very fast, okay? So this is a fastest method, right? Fastest convergence. Okay, so let me summarize Newton's method, presumably invented by Newton, but at least uses the calculus, which was invented by Newton. The idea then is that you start with some initial value, and then you use the calculus to find the slope of the tangent line to the curve, and where it intersects the x-axis becomes your next value. So you're basically approximating your curve by a straight line, okay? As you get closer and closer to the root, the straight line approximation becomes more and more accurate close to the root. So when you do that, you get your formula, which is xn plus 1 equals xn minus f of xn over f prime of xn. The only thing you need is a good initial guess for the root. Once you have a good initial guess, convergence is very rapid. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.